Hello everyone, and welcome back to part 2 of Beastbreaker with me, Mouse Plays Games. We're going to be playing some more of this because, as I mentioned in the last video, it's just really fun, and it's really cute, and I can be a little mouse, and I can pin-pon all over everything. So we're going to do just that. We've got a couple of attacks to do, and a quest there. I would like to grind for materials a bit. See if we can't see anything. Yeah, let's do this one. No bonus for the sword and shield, but we have two new weapons here. And I would like to try this one specifically. Because if I take a look at it again, we've got the We've got the standard reload roll for all bows. We've got diverting stings, which applies essence. I'm not sure what that is. 30% chance to deal 1 damage if it hits a scale, but if it hits an attacking core, it applies distract, which cancels attacks. So it could prevent us from taking some damage. This one applies taunt. When it hits core or scale. And when the taunt bar is filled, increases rampage count by 1, and it does not go down. So it'll prevent rampage. And we have siphon, which applies 1 damage at the end of a beast's turn if it's corroded. And if it's also, and if it has the corroded status, it deals a damage. Okay. So it should be a fairly good weapon set. Let's go here, here, and here. Okay. We've got 7. So we're going to use that to apply fire essence, which will prevent regenerations. We've learned it's a shard type. Okay, let's grab one of these, and then we'll fight it. So we've got a shard tusk crawler, pretty standard. We've fought a couple of these before, so let's just do a reload to get in here. So this fires 4 arrows in a straight line. If it hits a scale, there's 30% chance to deal damage. Okay. But it doesn't do damage to cores. So I'm guessing that this is the core that's attacking right now. There we go, we've stopped the attack. gain some charge from our leftover ammo. Because that's a mechanic of the game there. That's how we gain charge to use our abilities. Okay, let's do like that. And then we'll fire a corrosion onto there. And the other one as well. I actually want to just kind of keep my ammo there. Gain more charge like that. So this time we can kind of try to launch ourselves in here. Nope, wait, we just went right back out. Okay. Let's see. Let's do that. The taunt's full, so Rampage will not go down. Let's try and get back in here again. There we go. Okay, so I want to okay, so we've exposed that core, and we will corrode it. Then we will scoop up another reload roll there. And its taunted status is fading, apparently. So now, oh, there we go, we got the core break on that one. Let's do a reload in here. Oh, okay. And we'll siphon off this one. In fact, let's do it again because we can hit that one too. And then we'll reload. And pause there. All right. Reload by squeezing in that shimmer there. Let's do a wide shot and get a whole bunch of scales out of the way if we can. Fire off a siphon into that core and try and bounce it. There we go. Reload roll into here, try and get out of the way. Okay, we gotta do a distract. Oh, we hit the wrong one. Okay, it's fine. We gotta start destroying a couple of scales if we can. Oh, and that just went right back to me. Okay. go. Okay. We've got to build up our charge here. So let's just escape the attack range and settle there. It rampages in two turns, and we have not destroyed. Oh, there we go. Exactly what I needed. Perfect. So yeah, we're probably good for rampage. We've got a number of cores that are currently corroding as we need them to. Let's try and go over here. Let's do that. There we go. Let's hit another one. We'll try and do our main focus on this one. There we go. Then hit a reload to get our ammo back. And we'll be fully charged next turn. Yeah, we'll be okay. So let's do a reload this way. Nettling thorns on this side. Reload over this way. And hit the end there. Reload. We want to break as many of these as we can. Okay, it's taunted. There we go. Breaking a couple of those is our main priority, even though it will just re-defend, which is not what we want, admittedly. Okay, that's about to break. I think this time we just need to gather a couple of these and then hit some diverting stings to open a hole or two where we can. Get 30 charge. And we got it. Okay, so corrosion bow is a little bit of a slow burn, but it is somewhat consistent to what I see, at least. You know, it's just kind of like a set it and forget it sort of style. And it gives us a renown bonus, so that's certainly fine. Alright, you know what? Let's move on to the quest. I feel like my style is honestly more just swords, though. I like kind of just bouncing around and doing the damage we do. Okay, so we've got immediately three up here, two up here. Let's go down here. Three, one, settlement we can do. Can do our explosive essence. Let's try and find a thing here. We learned its element. It's only got two pools so far. So let's just attack it, yeah. Let's just get it before... Oh, we can't do that yet. Okay, so it's gonna get everything. Yeah, I said this a lot in the last episode, but the tracking for this is... It's not my favorite part of the game, admittedly, but... Yeah, see, it just gave me no time because I was apparently looking for somebody and I just tried to do the usual thing. I guess I shouldn't be bothering with materials or tracking or anything. Just look for it here. Okay, down here. Just go all over the map till we find what we're looking for. Still haven't. Where is it? There's no... Oh, okay. Well, we found who we're looking for, but we had no time for materials. And it's already got the last pool it wants, and it's right here. So... We don't... No, this is... I don't like tracking. I just don't like that part of the game. Anyway, it was down around here, right? So, waste less time this time. Skip it. We've already seen it. I just want to play the game now. And not lose this time. Okay, 9. That should be enough, right? Yeah, well, no. But that's fine. And this time it ambushes us? No. I don't understand. I don't understand. I'm gonna restart. I hit the quit button. And it's gonna be like, oh, game over. But it doesn't matter because nothing actually changed. That kind of bothers me too. Like, okay, it's down here. then we get this, then we get this, then we get this. Okay, so then, explosive essence. Oh, we need one more, come on. Well, we got ambushed again because this game just doesn't give enough turns, but at least this time we have all the stuff we wanted, so, yeah. I don't know. It just... Let's just open some holes in it, as we are wont to do, and then oh yeah, increased attack. There you go, eh? Okay, 5 turns of rampage, that's fine. We've got block. We want more block. Admittedly, we kind of want to try and get in there. I think expose that side of things. There we go. Let's do the same for... Can we actually maybe... Huh? Nope, we missed. That's fine. We only lost block. That's not the end of the world. Let's just try and insert ourselves into here with a shield bash. There we go. Hit as much as we can. Oh, no, come on, there we go. No, no, okay. Well, we bounced all over the place, but we didn't do barely anything. Fair enough, fair enough. Okay, really just need all these scales to go. Page in 3. Okay, we don't really have a good angle, so I'm not going to use defensive charge just yet. I'm just going to go for a strike, get these motes. We still got a little explosion off that took that down to one. Now we have a better angle. I'm going to defensive charge in here. Okay, that gave us a couple of bounces at least. And we're going to charge up. Okay, shield bash is at 23. I don't like that quite yet. Defensive charge, don't know if it'll really do much. I want to kind of try to strike in, get a little inroad first. We got our charge from that. That's good. Defensive charge, I will now do right there. Hoping to get like a couple of... Okay, well that was just a waste, so we'll get that back. And we blocked it. Okay. There we go. See, that's what we just kind of want to do. Clear out the scales. And then... damage that. Okay, that just went right up and down, huh? Okay. Clear out scales along the side there. Shield bash, we will go for... no, actually... get a couple of bounces there, that's fine. Strike is over there, let's hit it. Okay, spot flaw. Can we perhaps hit both cores? I'm gonna try. There we go, cracked both the cores at the same time. Okay, now we go for our now we go for a defensive charge. We want to kind of go in and bounce off both. Okay, there we go. Plenty of bounces. Expose the core there and do our damage to the other one as well, if we can. Block it, that's fine. Hit a strike there. Break it. Rampage reset. We do our damage to the crack. Okay, let's try and be a bit clever here. We'll get that. Okay. Our block is taking a lot of damage, but that's okay, because we can just do this. Now, both of them are one away from death, so we monkey around a little bit. We're gonna try and find a way to hit the other one before. There we go. And we hit both of them. Nice. We just get all those motes. I think it was a pretty good run. Pretty good run. Alright, Birdie, what's your deal? Well, you're an energetic one. Lord Dandelion. I kinda like you. You are a dandy. Wait, Lord Dandelion Gladiolus du Fritillaria the Fifth, heir to the Marquis of Summercrest in the hovering estates of the cloud. Okay, what's up, Dandy? Alright, we got our new companion, Lord Dandelion Gladiolus du Fritillaria the Fifth, heir to the Marquis of Summercrest. That is a mouthful and a half. Do you have anything to say? Nope. Nope. You've got something to say. Hi, grandmother. Okay, nothing we can craft. The hammer, okay. Alright, alright. We have a hammer, let's not take a look at it because we can't on the intro of a new weapon. But that's fine. A shard needle beak is our quarry. Very basic one. We gotta build up momentum for our basic. Okay, so gain one charge plus one charge for each inertia. On bounce deals one damage, splash five, and then stop. Okay. Concussive blow, stop on the second bounce at reverb 2, which deals X damage to target tile and all adjacent tiles. Okay. On first bounce, deal 2 damage in a large radius. Repeat for each inertia. While moving, deal 1 damage to everything in a small radius, plus 10 steps for each inertia. Okay. So, I guess we just kind of want a momentum towards it, maybe? Okay, we have inertia 1, so I guess every time we move, it gives us more inertia. So let's try an inertia towards this. There we go. We got almost full charge, which is good. Inertia 2, so then reverb 2 plus 2 for all inertia. So let's aim towards a tile that is advantageous, such as this one. Okay, or that. Okay, so that just moves around short little stances there. Okay, so I see what we have to do. We have to build up our inertia and charge, such as this way. Okay. I'm beginning to understand. Let's just do this then. I like the hammer weapon. I do. Because it can basically just immediately kill a beast like this if we hit it. Okay, so we need some more momentum here. Let's break this out. And then break this out so we get the funky dealer here. Yeah, because the problem with it is it only moves. Okay, the hammer spin deal. Well, we can do 1 damage to everything in a small radius plus 10 steps for each inertia. Okay, so it's only at 10 now. Yeah, I think I like the hammer a lot more than the sword, actually. I think it fits my style a lot better. Honestly, I'm just gonna go for this. Then I'm gonna go for... Yeah, then I'm gonna enter and see where it redirects. Okay. Okay, we want momentum. We want momentum here. Just to try and reach that. Okay, nope. Yeah, the big slammer is for when we end up in close range to something. So right now I'm just going to spam that and win. Set off so many explosions in the process. I do like the hammer though. I think that's the weapon we're going to try and use moving forward, if we can. And we get another renown level. Very good. And we get new armor as well. Okay. Maybe that'll give us more steps. New weapon available. Got new great hammer. We got sentinel's mail. Can we craft those? All your hammer abilities gain +2 inertia. Okay. Still nothing to craft. But that's okay. Okay, so out in the Bramble Hollow here, we gotta find clues for this, and we've also got a side quest. But let's take a look at the side quest there. I want more weapons, I want more armor. Okay, so I definitely want to take a look. Yeah, so that gives us more inertia, and that, wait, oh, we have to use a sword for this one. Okay, so hold on. Yeah, that's for ammo. Okay, use that with a sword. So let's just do that. Okay, we got 3 materials, 2 materials. No, not yet. Let's just go all the way down in here. Okay. We've got 9. We need a couple more. So let's just do that. Okay, so explosive essence, we'll go without the charge this time, and we'll just forward the walk here. We don't want it getting any of the pools that it doesn't need to. This is gonna be an easy battle. So all we gotta do, just expose the scales of this thing. Oh, Well, we got rid of those, at least. Scrow is 8. Level is 14. Okay, it's gonna basically restore itself, huh? Okay, well... that wasn't perfect, but it's fine. We'll deal some damage to the main. We'll do our defensive charge. Squeezing ourselves in between here. Damaging a ton of scales, which is fine with me. Rampage in 3 turns. Okay. We still have a rampage preventer, though, which is what we can remember to use if necessary. Got tons of block, nothing to worry about. Okay, shield bash in here. Rampage reset, that's good and fine. Take out that, take out that. Okay, good damage, good damage. Okay, I want a strike in here. I want a strike over here. Oh, okay, we used all of our block and we took damage. That's fine. I would like a defensive charge over here. Pick up the splinter, break a scale or two, finish it with a charge over here to get our charge back, or a strike rather. Yes. Okay, we're over here. I would like a little bit of this. I would like a little bit of this. Okay, rampage in 2 turns. So obviously we're going to be targeting here. And then the same area with a shield bash. It's already at 3 health on the main core, so I truthfully don't believe we have really anything to worry about. So we are simply going to end the battle. Here we get tons of modes. Shimmers and tangles and splinters all over the place. Hehe, pin-pon. Oh, this is good fun. Jolly good fun. Maybe I'll turn this into a full series. Maybe I'll rename these videos and just play this game. We get tons of renown from that, which is excellent. And what did we get? It's a nettles shearing sword. I guess they gave us the weapon after all. And Grandma likes to see it. A little sip of drink there. Wow, they were quite the team, huh? Alright, we got the Shearing Sword. Let's see it. So we got the strike, of course. Skewer Pyrrhus's cores. Okay. On Pyrrhus, halve the core health and gain 2 player health. And then, okay, Rupture. On core bounce, add 7 scar. When the beast's scar bar is filled, the grow of the beast is decreased by 3, and it will, and as well as scarred, it will not regrow scales. Okay. Damages scales in a chain, 1 damage each, for a total of X damage. Okay. On scale bounce, shatter 6. So I guess it just goes to through the adjacent scales? And deals 1, 2, 3... Oh, I like this weapon. Oh, I like it a lot. It is quite legendary indeed. What do we got to say? Alright, so apparently the pins are noble technology. Let's see what Dandelion has to say. I guess that heart is his own little pin there, and it's sort of like a camera and sort of like a camera phone, basically. I don't know. Interesting technology. Still nothing we can craft. Yeah, doesn't really do much with the crafting part of it, does it? In this, at least in this part of the game. So, sword, new sword. I like it. I like new swords. We're gonna use that probably for a long while. Okay. Alright, so let's use the scouting ability and we'll just roll up this area here. Okay, we've got stuff. I like stuff. So let's get these. Let's go over here. Okay, let's go over here. Let's let it pass for now. We want these. We'll go down here. We want these. Okay. I want this. This. I don't know what that clock on there is, but I don't like it. Okay, where's our beastie at? There we are. Hello. We have no choice but to fight. Okay. That's fine. Alright, so shearing sword. Let's run it out. Let's see what we can do. So basic strike. The charge abilities are pretty high cost, but that's fine. As long as we break our bonuses. Okay, so on core bounce, add 7 scar. Okay, so let's scar it. There we go. Its scar is filled, but we'll take damage. That's fine, though. So it's not going to regrow scales as it is right now. Okay, so let's try and aim for this. Okay, we rampage is in 5 turns because it didn't really get much there, so that's fine. Okay, we are in a bit of a problem here. We're not getting any block. No, we missed. Okay, this isn't... The shearing sword is not actually working very amazingly for us here. I mean, it's doing a bunch of damage, truthfully, but it's not damaging in the ways that we want it to. So let's scar it again, and while we're at it, blow this up. Okay, we just died. Okay, so... having no defense is actually not great. We end up in the area of effect for quite a lot of times unintentionally, and it just deals huge damage to us. Okay, well, these don't matter, because they don't actually affect the story at all, so... nonetheless, Shearing Sword kinda didn't do great on its first trial run. Let's try again, though. We'll use our ability, give me... give me all of these squares, I guess. Okay, plenty of materials up here. We got another hint. Okay, so I see a pool that it's gonna go for down there. That'll be the one that we want to get to. Okay. We'll just head it off here. We'll do a little sneak attack before it gets the last one. Okay, hopefully this time it will go a little bit better. Because we are going to... okay, so the shear is the one we want. So let's just instantly do that. And throw ourselves in here. Okay, so shear will break. Okay, I don't think we want to use that yet. Let's just do another strike. Break some more things here as we do. Okay, so, shear. Let's hit this one. Okay, good. Yeah, so then, rupture. Now it won't regrow those scales, right? That's how it is. But we're still in the AoE. So it's gonna kill us. Very hard. Okay, okay, and now what I want to do is basically just try and escape the AoE and not bounce right back into it, please. Okay, good. I don't like that we have to basically waste a turn doing that, but let's just try and keep it from scarring shit. Okay. And we can shear off... over here. Rampage reset. It's good. Let's shear off over here. Okay, so good that we're shear. The shearing sword has its uses, definitely. Problem is, though, it just isn't, like, keeping us as safe as I would like. But I mean, maybe it's better to just end a turn here. then we'll scoop in on it. And we'll hit a shear. No, we can't. So let's just do that. Yeah, that'll be fine. Because it's still barely regrowing anything, so... There we go. As long as we end up out of the AoE... Oh jeez, I didn't want to end my turn. Oops. Okay, that was a mistake. We really need to blow this up right now or else we lose. Okay, that's not good. That's really not good. We're fine though. We gotta blow it up. I misplayed pretty hard there. I'm not gonna lie. But we still got plenty of emotes, that's fine. Okay. So, testing out the Shearing Sword. You gotta stay out of the AoEs, I guess that's the main thing. You know, I wasn't really used to it because of how long I used that other sword. It just gave me enough block to not care. So, that's certainly fine enough, though. We'll get another Renown level with our beautiful Shearing Sword, and we get a clue. Your clover blossom tea, and that's what farming is. So I want to go on this one now. I want to do... I want to do our hammer time this time. Okay, so... Dandy can summon... Let's you craft from anywhere on the map without spending a turn. Okay. That could be useful. We learned the element of the beast. It's a forge striker tooth. Okay. So let's get all these materials here. Use Dandy. Use on settlement. Okay. Get our explosive essence. And then just charge into battle. Okay. So we got a forged striker tooth. One of these babies again. Okay. So our bonus tile, I believe, would be out of reach this time, I think. We could try and sneak in, maybe, over here? Okay, no. That's what I thought. Okay. Let's just do that. Okay, so Inertia 2 has built up everything. Okay, so let's just beat it up. I Okay, so I don't know which core is attacking here, so let's go over there. In fact, we'll do that twice, and we'll beat it up. Okay. And then inertia 2, and we beat it up. And we beat it up. And then, yeah, we're just gonna try and sneak our way through here. Grab all those. Grab all these and then beat it up. Okay, hammer was a perfect choice for this one. That's simply the fact. So let's grab some stuff. And then keep our inertia with this by just beating them up. Okay, so let's go over here. And then beat them up. We'll take damage, that's fine. 5 damage is nothing at this stage in the game. So let's go over here and beat him up. Okay, let's go use our 2 actions here and beat him up. Then we'll use 2 actions here, and we'll be, oh, nope, just missed it. Okay, so that doesn't matter though, doesn't matter. Okay, we want more charge than that, admittedly, so. Kind of stuck in a bit of a position here, but that's okay. Let's just get all our charge back and try and work our way back towards things here. Okay. Zoom our way towards it and then beat him up. Okay, simple mission. I really like the hammer for those striker tooth bean beans. Getting plenty of emotes too. Nice. Can enchant with 2 sparks. And we're upgrading the forge. I guess. Okay. Unlock 2 spark crafting. Perfect. That's just what I want to do. momentum and battering ram plus 5 steps for each inertia. Deal 1 damage for every 4 steps traveled. Okay. We got a strike and spot flaw. We got rupture and shear. We got strike and skewer. Okay, that's a new. We got leaping bash, which pierces everything. And on stop deals 1 damage in a medium radius, plus 1 damage for each inertia. Okay, and then shatter 2. And then add 2 stun. Okay. Well, that's a pretty basic moral quandary there, admittedly. Oh no, what if you have to save the bad people? Okay, so we're going with them this time. So we've got the okay, so we can do parts this time. So this is so we can do that, or we can do the leaden half, which is momentum and battering ram. I think what I want to do is that with that, because that is my favorite abilities. It's got the reverb ability, which I like, and it's got deal 1 damage in medium radius plus 1 damage for each inertia. Pierces everything. So that's just, yeah. And this is shatter and stun, which is also great. We don't want things to move when we're trying to hammer them into next week. Keep our hammer armor as well there. Okay, so gather materials from that space and all surrounding spaces. Okay, so we've got 3, 2, 1, 1, and then there's nothing there. So let's try and get. Let's get that. Plus 7 materials instantly. Okay. Perfect. And then we'll go trek down here. There's our beast. We learned the element of the beast. Okay. Where are you going here, bud? Okay, good. So much like this, our goal is kind of... Oh, look at all that, huh? Oh, dear. It's kind of really going everywhere, isn't it? Just straight up everywhere. But that's okay. We'll just stop there and then we'll go there. Take out a couple of scales. Okay, so it's the thorns that it launches. That's its big deal there. Okay. Okay, so let's take that out. And then Leaping Bash pierces everything, deals one damage in a medium radius plus one damage for each inertia. Okay. And that's Shatter 2 plus one Shatter for each inertia. I kind of want to just go with this for now. And then just, yeah, break all of this base. Oh, right. It does one bounce and then stops. Okay. But that's fine. We'll want to build up the inertia for that right now. So we'll just do that. Yeah. Okay, we got a little bit of damage. That's fine. Where even are we? Oh my goodness. Okay, let's build up the inertia here. Okay, wait. Pyrrhus is everything. Oh, okay. So that shows me where it's going to stop. So we want to try and stop it right here. Yeah? Okay, get our momentum up. And let's go right over here. Okay, learning to use this hammer. Learning to use this hammer. That's what we want to do. Okay, so we want more momentum right now. Build up our inertia, build up our momentum. Okay, so Clangorous Barrage, Shatter 2 plus 1 Shatter for each inertia. So okay, that shatters a ton. Shatters a ton. Rampage in one turn. Okay, that's not good. So maybe can we okay, good. Solve the rampage of that little dealio. Still learning about Clangorous Barrage though, so we want okay, so it adds the stun on core bounce. Okay. Which is that in and of itself. So I want to kind of use the leaping to kind of break these. That's kind of my strategy. And then shatter using this. Okay, bonus tiles over there. Okay, concussive blow did not stop that. Okay. The momentum is our problem simply for... We only have a limited amount of charge. If we get more charge, like, I feel like we would be a lot more powerful. Okay, rampage in one turn. This could be a little bit difficult here. Okay, so that's how our rampage stopper works here. We get a couple of healing items. We're not getting the you know, the tiles that we need here. Okay, we need that. We need our inertia up on everything here. And we just need to start taking out some things here. Concussive blow I'm liking less and less because it's not that it does damage, it's that it bounces and then does damage, which I just kind of find hard to figure out every now and then. Okay, so Shatter 5, yeah. We want to start shattering things. And shattering our bonus tiles. Okay, bonus tile is pretty out of reach. Okay, so let's see if we can't maybe do this. Okay. Then can we do this? Five damage is nothing. Okay, that's fine. A little bit awkward with that hammer. I think I liked the other one a little bit more so far, but still kind of worked out. We're learning how to use it. We'll gain another renown level. We'll get a couple of motes. So Cinnabar's got some secrets, and we have discovered a new area, the Misty Mires. But for now, I think I'm going to end this episode of Beastbreaker here. Let's get a couple of weapon parts, just 'cause we can. Oh, I guess that's one thing we didn't upgrade is armor back there as well. Let's do a little battle here. Let's put some armor parts together. So this is gain 20 charge when you damage this tile. Oh, okay. So armor is just armor here. Gain one action. Okay. Gain 5 ammo. Yeah. So armor is a lot more basic than weapons, it seems, for now at least. So we'll keep with that. Okay. And as far as our hammer here, so the tremor on bounce, stop on the second bounce. Okay, so it's not. Okay. And then reverb 2, which is deal X damage to target tile on all adjacent tiles. Okay. Okay. So. We've also got this one, which is deal 1 damage for every 4 steps traveled. And then we've got our big slammer here. Unbounce, deal 2 damage in a large radius, repeat for each inertia. So that's the one. This is basically Dandy's hammer. Because the hammer, the big slammer there is the attack that I actually was thinking of wanting to use, but if I could get one that's like big slammer and a combination of big slammer and like leaping bash or one of these two, maybe. I like leaping bash more. That did a lot of damage. If I could get a combination of big slammer and leaping bash, I would probably set that as my hammer and keep it there. Because those are my two favorite attacks. I just love Big Slammer. Big Slammer is my friend. Big Slammer will protect me. But another thing I guess we might need is probably a bit more block. Because we do end up taking a lot of damage. Unless we've blocked ourselves into an infinite loop there. But anyway, weapons and such, that can all be figured out in any of future episodes that I do, because for now we're going to end this episode, and of course thank you once again to Vodeo Games for kind of providing this review key. This has been great fun, and I'm really glad that I reached out. I hope in the future we can work together again, but for now, I'm going to end the episode, so make sure to follow me on Twitter and Twitch. Those links will be in the description. And goodbye, and good night, everyone. Mousy out.